Welcome back to Furuno Connections. In this episode, we finish up our chart plotter shootout by covering tides, currents, boundaries, and weather. These are all critical aspects of navigating your boat, catching fish, and getting home safely. So let's get started. Let's talk to Captain Jack Carlson.
So the Furuno TZT-3 includes all your tide tables right in the unit, straight from the factory. It's very easy to access your tides with the edge swipe. Swipe out, hit your tides. It's gonna call up your nearest tide station. You can see how strong the tide is gonna be as well on the graph. But let me tell you what, this is very important whether you're navigating in shallow waters for the bit larger vessels, or even fishing. The fish definitely bite better on different tides. And having this information right at your fingertips not only will increase your catch, but if you're in a big yacht, it may even save you a lot of damage to your boat.
So one of the really cool features we've included with TZ Touch 3 is the ability to graph perpetual tides and currents. You never have to update them, they're always in the machine. So whenever I go in, I can just swipe up my layers menu, turn on tide heights and currents, and instantly have all the tide icon and current icons appear. If I touch my tide in this area, you can see I can see the Hawk Channel tides, or if I want to check currents, I can just pop out of that, hit the current hour right here, check currents. If I want to graph tides or currents, I can hit the graph button that's included in that page and instantly bring up the tide and current graphs. It's so simple to use. It's an easy way to check exactly what's going on as far as your navigation. Moon phase as well as sunrise and sunset are also included in the current and tide icons.
Knowing your boundary lines are very important, because that could be the difference between getting a ticket or not getting a ticket. For example, Sombrero Key is a no-take zone, so this would be a great area to set up your boundary lines.
You can set alarms, so if I want to, I can set my alarm and automatically know as I approach the boundary when I'm getting too close. It's really important for commercial fishermen who are working with MLPAs or different areas where they know there's no take zones, and if they break that boundary, they're in trouble. So this is a great way to be safe and understand your location and how you are with respect to these boundaries.
It does give you tides, so we're gonna quick go to menu, and we're gonna press layer, and then we're gonna go to chart. And then here you see on the right-hand corner, it gives you tides and currents. So I'm just gonna turn both of them on, zoom out here. And here you see it gives you tide direction and
yeah, the different tide stations,
yeah,
right,
exactly.
Let you know what's going on out there. And you know, I've gotta believe, you know, I know you guys go offshore, so tide might not be a factor,
right.
But for the people who fish inshore.
Inshore, yeah,
you know,
I mean, I'll bet, you know, if you're gonna take the skiff out, you know, and take a guest out in the skiff, that information is definitely going to be useful.
Oh yeah, you're using those tides almost every time you're fishing, especially in that shallow, you know.
Right.
That's how your bite is affected. You know, that's
right.
How these fish eat. So
right.
It's super important to play your tides correctly to be able to produce when you need to.
Okay, well, while we were in the menus playing around with System A, we found the boundary setup. So let's just walk through how to do that. You press the menu button, and on System A, we choose layers, and then user data. And what we can do is turn on boundaries. Once we have boundaries turned on, we can click the drop-down box and we can add a new boundary. So I'm going to do it in the area we're in right now. We can choose from creating a boundary via a line, an area, or a circle. So I'm just going to use circle for something different. As we see, if we just read the screen, it says set center. So I'll tap on the screen and I'll say this is center. Okay, from there we can set the radius of our circle. So we'll just drag it out. And if you see, we kind of have that turquoise line on the screen. If we wanted to, you know, move it around this area here, encompass this very shallow area, we can just set the radius. And now we have a boundary around that area and it's done. If we want to edit it, we can change the name. If we have a specific name, the System A defaults name to a number. So we'll call it Circle 001. But if we want to edit that, we can definitely do it. If we want to delete it from this point, we can do it too.
On System B, as we look at the chart, we have plenty of tide stations to choose from in the area. With a quick glance, you can see the tides coming up or going down. If you want to get more information, you simply tap on the tide station. When the depth comes up, you just tap on it, and from there you get a full tide screen. Now you can tap on any area you want, and it will tell you what the tides are going to be in that particular time frame. Or you can use the knob and just pick a time you're going to be out on the water, and it'll tell you where the tide is going to be at that time. Currents are shown on the screen as well, but they're not as easy to spot as the tides. To view the current, you need to tap on the icon and get the current speed pop-up box. Tap on the current speed box to open the current graph. As for creating boundaries on the chart, we could not find an option to create boundaries on System B. The only way to create some type of boundary would be to create a route using the different points in the route to outline your boundary.
Now, Captain Cam, we've been out, you know, running around testing these units all day. You know, one thing we haven't really talked about that much are tides. How do tides come into play when you're out here fishing?
Yeah, so tides come into play almost in every aspect, especially when I'm fishing closer to shore and not offshore fishing. Mm-hmm. Tidal fishing, for instance, when we go out fishing for cobias a lot in the Florida Bay, they tend to show up a lot more in the slack tide, which is actually a tide that is in between the high and the low, where it's changing. So just kind of knowing the tides around here is a very huge part of fishing.
We're going to show you how you find your tide stations and how you show tides on your screen. You know, let's zoom out here a little bit, and let's say we wanted to find tides, you know, down here in this area around Ohio Key. We're going to touch and hold on the screen. We're going to have to go to more options. We then have to go to find nearest. And then once we get to find nearest, we can then click on our tides button. And what it's going to do is it's going to bring up our nearest tide station. We're going to click on that nearest tide station. Then we also have to hit more info. Now that we've done all that, now we can take a look at our tide table. And we can see that we're basically in that slack tide around Ohio Key that Cam was talking about. So we're getting ready to have an incoming tide here.
To view currents on System C, you have to find the current icon, which you do not see as many of them as the tide stations. Press and hold the icon to get the pop-up menu, tap on More Options, and then select Current Station. This will bring up the current graph. It's important to note that this is a totally different menu than the Tide Station menu. System C does not have a boundary function. The only way to create some type of boundary would be to create a route like we did on System B, using the different points in the route to outline your boundary area. All four systems are able to display tides and currents, but TZ Touch 3 makes it really simple with an edge swipe from the right side of the screen or a tap of the icon on the chart. Both TZT 3 and System A are able to draw dedicated boundaries, while System B and C do not have that capability.
All right, guys, so I just came over to Captain Jack's boat from testing System A all day, and one of the things we talked about with System A is the only weather service you can get is a paid subscription through Sirius. And that's a great way to get weather if that's your only option. On System A, that is the only option. But with Furuno, we came over to Captain Jack's boat because we not only offer Sirius weather service as well, we also offer a free non-subscription service as well from NavCenter Weather. And I came over to show Captain Jack exactly how to use this. We're sitting in the marina where he takes off from every day. It's actually the perfect place to connect to Wi-Fi and get that free weather download that only takes seconds to download. So what I want to do first, Captain Jack, is I'm going to show you how to set it up.
Okay.
So before we get our first weather download, we're going to go into settings and scroll down to the weather page because I want you to tell me what you want to see. So out of the box, we have wind, waves, cloud, rain and snow, pressure, and sea surface temperature automatically selected. That's our default settings. But when I was on some of the other boats with your other captains, they said they really wanted to have oceanic currents and altimetry as well. Is that something you're interested in?
Yes, it is. The clouds don't need so much.
Okay.
But definitely wind I'd like, waves I like, rain or snow. Like that's good to have for the rain.
For the rain portion,
snow
right
here.
Yeah, right.
Air temperature, you know, it's okay, but I feel how much, you know, I feel what that is. Sea surface temperature, ocean currents, and altimetry.
Okay.
Looks good to me.
So once you got everything set up, you'll never have to go back in and do this again. This is what we're going to download every time we get a weather download at this point.
Okay? Let's check it out.
Okay, so now that we're sitting at just a regular chart plotter screen, we're going to press the home button, and we have a dedicated weather page. It's this guy right here, so we'll just tap on it. And now the most important thing you need to know about the weather page is it's going to download weather for what you're looking at on the screen right now. So what we don't want to do is hit get weather data, because right now we're only at a 3.5 mile scale.
Gotcha.
Not much weather coming in there. So what we're going to do is we're going to zoom in, zoom out quite a bit. And let's say we go to, man, you got a lot of points.
Let's get rid of those points.
Yeah, that's probably a good idea to clear it up for everybody. Okay, so now we're at 177 miles, so we're going to get weather for the 177 miles surrounding us. And we get that information by simply tapping on the screen and clicking on Get Latest Weather. You're going to get a connection to the server on the screen. It takes about 10 to 20 seconds. You see it's preparing the weather file already. We see that the weather update's in progress. And in just a few seconds, we're going to have weather for that 180 mile area.
So it's pretty much going to say zero the whole time.
And then it just, boom, goes to 100.
It's going to go to 100. Zero to 100.
Zero to 100. There you go. Done. So about 20 seconds. And the cool part is immediately you start seeing information on the screen. So no matter where we want to go, I mean, we see where the boat is in the center of the screen. But if we tap anywhere, and you can see where the weather cutoff is. So if we zoom out, this is the area of weather we just downloaded.
And that's because we had that up in the screen.
Absolutely.
And that's what we
Absolutely. If we wanted to get weather for the entire United States, we could have just zoomed in or zoomed out to the entire United States. But the cool part is, so we're looking at all this information. If we tap on the screen anywhere, we can get information about the area we just tapped in. So wind force and direction, wave heights, wave periods. That's a lot of good information.
Absolutely. Well, and also wind force too, because a lot of times we're in here and it can seem windy,
right?
But you know what, especially like on a north wind, but a lot of times now we fish 20, 30, 40 miles in the swordfish grounds. The wind could be a lot less out there.
And absolutely.
Knowing that information in advance is definitely an advantage we need.
And the cool part is, Jack, is remember when we set up in the menu all the things we wanted to see? We don't have to flood the screen with all that information. We can select it right here on the weather page. So we simply look at the screen here, we scroll down, and we say weather data. We pop it up. This is all the information we said in the main menu we wanted to download every time we download weather.
Exactly.
But if we don't want to have all that information on the screen, we don't have to, but we can. So we can turn
Added
on waves. We can turn on, let's say, currents and altimetry. Okay. So now we have all that information on the screen as well. We'll just get rid of that and we'll start taking a look around. And we can see the direction of current flow. We can see where the changes take place. We have our wind vane, so we know what direction the wind's coming from. And we can also look for areas of upwelling and, you know, basic altimetry information that I would imagine, not being a full-time fisherman like you are, that's got to be some good information.
Oh, definitely. Like knowing the currents and the way the winds are going. Also, you know, the temperature breaks. That's a big thing to us. You know, we buy reports that actually tell us that. But having this free and available to us from Furuno, that is a money saver. And it gives us the edge of knowing where the fish are.
And the cool part about it is, Jack, it doesn't matter if you hook it to, so we can hook the TZT3 up to the hotspot on our cell phone. We can hook it to the Wi-Fi here at the marina. And like we saw, in 20 seconds, the weather's downloaded and we have it. The default is download weather for 4 days. You can download it once per day to keep it the most updated. Or, you know, if you're going on a trip, you can download it for up to 14 days.
Awesome. So now once I have it downloaded here and I go offshore and I want to get a new reading, how do I do that?
Once you're offshore, if you're too far offshore, you can't get a new reading unless you have a serious subscription. So remember, we have to have either a cellular connection. We got to connect this unit to Wi-Fi to update the free weather data. Once that's done, you know, we can just use it until we get back to a spot where we can update it again.
So all I really need, though, is cell phone service with the hotspot.
Absolutely. That really is all you need. And
that's
so
great.
If you're only 3 miles off the coast, I mean, we've been out, you know, 3 miles pretty much all day today, and I still had good cell phone service.
Yes, I mean, actually, I get service a lot of times 10 to 12 to 15 miles out. So, you know, finding that Gulf Stream, the inside, shouldn't be an issue for me at all.
Right, I wouldn't think so. And the other cool part I like about this, if you just want to see what the weather's going to do throughout the day, you can either drag your finger along the bar and just watch changes take place, see what the wind vanes are doing.
That's awesome.
Or we can also animate it and just let it play through and sit here and watch what's going to happen.
So, Tim, how often is this updated?
Well, Jack, you know, it's interesting. Nav Center weather is updated on a 12 or 24 hour increment schedule. So say for instance, you're leaving here early in the morning, let's say you leave at 6 a.m. if you were to go out there and be offshore at noon and you tried to update it again, you're going to get the same information because it won't then again be updated until 6 p.m. that night. So as long as what you're doing as a fishing boat captain is updating it while you're here in the marina every morning before you leave, you're going to have the most current information. And the other cool thing about this NavCenter weather software is it's available anywhere in the world. If you have a Sirius subscription, you know, that's a U.S.-based company, and just the satellites are above us. If you're over in, you know, Europe or Asia or anywhere like that, you can't access Sirius weather. But this NavCenter weather does work there.
That's awesome, man. Worldwide.
Worldwide.
All four systems are able to utilize the Sirius XM subscription-based marine weather with an add-on module. However, TC Touch 3 is the only system that offers a built-in, free weather service that not only offers weather for North America, but worldwide. Well, that finishes up our chart plotter testing. Hopefully, this gives you a good feeling on how all four systems stack up side by side when it comes to ease of use, speed, and the number of touches it takes to do simple chart plotting tasks. In the next episode, we've got something special for you. We figured, who better for you to get a first-hand impression of the systems from than the captains and the crew? We're going to sit down with them and see how they thought TC Touch 3 stood up against the competitors. So make sure you join us for the next episode. You're not going to want to miss this. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you like, subscribe, and click on the bell below to get notifications for the next time we release new videos. Thanks a lot, and we'll see you next time.